If you need to hire, you need Indeed. Indeed is your matching and hiring platform with over 350 million global monthly visitors, according to Indeed data, and a matching engine that helps you find quality candidates fast. And Indeed doesn't just help you hire faster. 93% of employers agree Indeed delivers the highest quality matches compared to other job sites, according to a recent Indeed survey. With Indeed, everything hiring is all in one place, and it makes it so easy. Leveraging over 140 million qualifications and preferences each day, Indeed's matching engine is constantly learning from your preferences. The more you use Indeed, the better it gets. Join the more than 3.5 million businesses worldwide that use Indeed to hire great talent fast. And listeners of this show will get a $75 sponsored job credit to get your jobs more visibility at Indeed.com/podcast. Just go to Indeed.com/podcast right now and support our show by saying you heard about Indeed on this podcast. Terms and conditions apply. Indeed.com/podcast. Need to hire? You need Indeed.
Welcome to another episode of Anything But Murder, Shorty.
Yay!
I'm Karen Devaney.
I'm Ann Varner.
Yay! That's who we are.
Indeed.
Okay.
It's a lovely Saturday afternoon.
It's a little chilly willy for South Kakalaki.
Yeah, a little chilly.
We're in May. We're in the middle of May.
Yeah.
And it was 64 degrees on the way over here.
Wow.
It was 65 at my house by the time I got here. The temperature had dropped a degree.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's
when
chilly.
I got back from the grocery store this morning, there was a little tiny baby gator swimming around looking for some sunshine in my pond.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
If I had a fireplace, it would be on today.
Oh, my God.
It would definitely be on today, but I ain't got nary, so it ain't on.
Yeah.
Well, so I just came
sit
over
out
here.
Your fire pit.
I can, but they took all the chairs away because of the Rona.
Oh, that's right.
So you can't, and they took all the wood away. So I'm just sit there.
Yes.
Which I do. We walk down to the water sometimes and we sit on the edge of the fire pit and look at the water.
Right.
But they have opened up the docks and they put the picnic tables back out.
Right.
So we can go sit under the gazebo.
A little. I
know. I'm ready for our pool to open.
Yes.
That's what I'm waiting for.
You know what I'm waiting for? A nice Bloody Mary brunch with some steak and eggs,
God,
a Bloody Mary,
too.
A cup of coffee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know.
Downtown Charleston.
Somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere.
Mm-hmm. That would be so delightful.
Yeah.
Delightful.
Yes.
So today, since it's a shorty, I got this game off the interweb called Bless Your Heart. It's from the editors of the Garden and Gun magazine, which we both love. I enjoy that magazine.
Yeah. I actually am starting to like that better than Southern Living. And I've been a Southern Living fan for many, many, many
years. You really
years.
Have stuck by them, I think, the longest of any of us.
Because
I kind of gave up on them about a year and a half ago.
Yeah, it's tough. Cause
it's just gotten to be all ads.
It's a lot of ads and not as many recipes. And it used to be like in the summer, to beginning of the summertime, they would put a list of great Southern books to read for the summer. And I haven't seen that in a while.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
They're missing.
It really has changed.
Yeah.
So we're on the Garden and Gun, and we enjoy that one. So this is a trivia game. So
I love it. I'm so excited.
Prove your Southern know-how.
Woo-hoo.
So I don't know. Hopefully we don't lose our Southern card today.
I know. And I mean, we might have to edit some stuff out if we
if we suck real bad. If y'all hear us go, well, and then I said.
Right.
Then you know that we took some out.
Should have thought about making cue cards before.
Oh my gosh, I know, because we didn't even look at any of the cards at all.
That was probably poor planning.
It's okay. It's okay. This is our authentic selves, and I can assure anybody that's listening that we have our Southern cards and we will never lose them.
We will not lose.
You will have to pry it out of my dead cold hands before. So
also with this game, I'll drop along the way came a little recipe book on things that you can serve at a nice Southern social gathering.
I love a Southern social gathering.
The first one that strikes me as interesting is Martha Hall Foose's bacon crackers.
Well, I don't know who Martha Hall Foose is, but good for her for getting a recipe in this.
It is a savory game night snack from the Mississippi Delta.
No.
And it serves six. Yes.
Nice.
Listen to it. This is, I love it. I just love it. 3/4 pound of thin sliced bacon, which is about 16 slices.
Okay.
42 rectangular butter crackers, such as a club.
I love a club.
Or a captain's wafer.
Stop it with a captain's wafer.
Or a Waverly cracker.
Oh my gosh. Yes.
So you're going to heat your oven to 250 degrees. Mm-hmm. You're going to slice the bacon slices into thirds, crosswise. Okay. And you're going to wrap each cracker with a piece of bacon.
It's a cracker wrapped in bacon.
It is.
I mean, you can't get any better than that.
That's right. You're going to put them all on your bacon sheet. Well, actually, you're going to put them on a wire rack over your bacon sheet.
Yeah, so the fat will drip down.
Yes. And then you're going to bake it for an hour and a half. So your kitchen's going to smell good,
oh my
bacony.
Gosh.
Yeah.
This
and
just sounds
and you
delightful.
Do it, you bake it until your bacon becomes crisp. Mm-hmm. Then you're going to cool it, and then you serve it. That's it.
Oh, my Lanta.
Thank
that
you,
sounds
Hall.
So yummy.
Martha Hall Foos.
You could even make up a little ranch dip to go with that.
Or I was thinking a port wine cheese would be delightful.
Oh, my gosh, to spread it on there.
Yeah.
Mm-mm-mm, girl.
Yeah.
Or even some pimento cheese.
Oh, girl. Yeah, pimento cheese, I got you.
You got it? You got the recipe? Okay.
Yes.
Where does this come from?
This one, it's just a basic recipe. It doesn't say where it comes from.
Okay.
But it's got all the ingredients that we use in ours.
Okay.
2 cups of sharp orange cheddar.
Yes.
Grated. 1/2 cup of Duke's mayonnaise.
That's very important.
Now, that is important.
It is
Don't
important.
Don't use Miracle Whip.
No.
Don't use Hellman's, for God's sake.
No, it's Duke's.
Duke's mayonnaise.
That's it.
Or just don't make it.
That's true.
Don't make it.
Don't make it.
Right.
Walk away.
1/2 cup of pimento peppers.
Okay.
1/2 cup of green onion chopped.
Mm-hmm.
1 teaspoon of black pepper. Also important because you want to have that little kick.
Mm-hmm.
1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper with a little dash of Tabasco.
Now, I will say that when we make ours, I don't use the jars of pimento peppers.
No, we roast our own.
We take red pepper and just roast it either in the oven or over top of the burner. And then you can just get a little bit of a char on it, peel that char back so you're not eating charcoal,
mm-hmm.
and then slice up that softened part of the pepper. Mm-hmm. Just chop it up real fine.
Yeah.
So that's what we've done.
Yeah, remember we took that class. They taught us how to make it.
Oh, so good.
We took a class. We used to have a store here that was delightful called Southern Season, and they had cooking school, a big cooking school, like really nice, and you could sign up for classes, and one of the classes they taught us how to make pimento cheese.
Yeah, girl.
It was delicious.
It was so good.
I mean, everything was delicious, but I just remember wanting more of that pimento cheese.
Yes, so. Well, and then we made it. I've made it a couple of times.
We did. Mm-hmm. We certainly have.
Yeah.
It's easy.
It is easy, and it's a good Southern snack.
It is. So, bacon wafer, pimento cheese.
Heaven on a cracker.
Yeah, let's talk. Let's do some trivia.
Okay.
Let's see what we know.
So you have 4 categories to choose from. Travel and places.
Okay.
That's one. Food and drink.
Okay.
That's two. And then, hold on, I'm going to get it. Sports and culture.
Woo!
And then literature and arts.
Lord have mercy.
I know. So pick your not your culture. Pick your category.
Let's try food and drink because
yeah.
I might have a chance.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Okay. This mini-layered stacked dessert traces its roots to a Maryland oyster and crab oasis on the Chesapeake. What is it?
It's a dessert, you said?
Yes. Now, is it easier for me to give you, because I just don't think you're just going to come up with this. Do you want me to give you the choices?
I think you should.
Okay. Is it bread pudding, rum raisin bread, Smith Island cake, or frozen custard?
I would go somewhere between bread pudding and Smith Island cake.
We're going to have to choose one because there's not an in-between.
But I don't know what a Smith Island cake is. Lord have mercy.
Don't.
I'm not allowed to Google it.
No,
I just want to know what a Smith Island cake is.
Well, it's going to tell you the answer, I'm sure, if you
What's
guess
the
things.
Answer?
Smith Island cake.
Okay.
All right. And that's because Smith Island is a little place in the Chesapeake.
I understand that, but I still don't know what a Smith Island cake
is. Well, I really think bread pudding is a northern thing.
I concur, but yeah. You never know. Sometimes people try to trick you.
Okay, well, there you go.
Should I ask you a question now?
Yeah.
I should.
I agree.
What category do you want?
I'm going to try, oh my gosh. So I think food and drink is the easiest category, so I'm going to not go there. I'm going to go with travel and places.
Would that be travel and places? Okay, here we go. Juleps are traditionally made with bourbon, ice, simple syrup, and what kind of herb?
Mint. And that's in travel and places?
Can you be more specific about your mint? Is it basil, spearmint, peppermint, oregano?
Spearmint.
You got it.
Yeah, girl.
Spearmint. As a matter of fact, they sent us a recipe for the mint julep, and I'll tell you how it goes. I'll tell you how to do it. You take a tablespoon of superfine sugar, 2 tablespoons of hot water, 8 mint leaves plus 1 mint sprig for garnish, and 2 ounces of bourbon.
I like that bourbon part.
Yep. So you're going to dissolve your sugar in the water, add your mint leaves, press them lightly with a spoon to release the oil, add bourbon, fill the glass with cracked ice, stir, and garnish with your sprig.
I love it.
Easy to the peasy.
Yes.
I loved it. The first question was about the mint julep.
Well, since I got it right, I get to go again.
Yes, you do. Same category?
Sure.
New category?
We'll do it the same.
Travel and places. All right. The frying pan, a hulking steel structure off the coast of North Carolina, operates as a research center and bed and breakfast in a space that was formerly a what? A Coast Guard light tower, a cruise ship, an oil rig, or a desert island?
A Coast Guard station?
You got it.
My gosh, I got my Southern cord and I'm not letting it go.
You're on fire.
I want to do a different category.
Okay.
Let's do the culture one. I don't know what the culture.
Sports and culture.
Yeah, this might do me in, people.
This tiny Texas town is known to be an artistic oasis, especially after minimalist artist Donald Judd moved here in 1971. Tiny Texas town known to be an artistic oasis.
All right, you're going to have to give me the options.
Marfa, Austin, Lubbock, or Waco?
I'm going with Lubbock. Was it Austin?
No, it was Marfa.
I would have never known.
Yeah, I don't know what Marfa is.
I don't know a lot about Texas.
I don't either, but we know Texas murders, but.
Right. Well, and I know people got exes in Texas.
All my exes live in Texas. All right. So there you go. You're winning.
Winning. Tiger blood.
What does that mean?
That was the stuff that Charlie Sheen was going on about when he was ranting about winning, and then he was talking about tiger blood.
Oh, my God.
Maybe he knew something we didn't back then about the tiger. Was that show? The Tiger Tales?
Oh, the Tiger King or something?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, is Charlie Sheen even alive?
I think he is.
Oh, wow.
Okay, what would you like to do now?
Well, I guess I'll go whatever the culture one was, because you told me the easiest one was food. And
well,
drink.
I mean, I just feel like that's going to be the easiest for us because we love food and drink. All right, let's go. Here we go.
All right, let's do it.
Brownie Wise lived in Florida in the 1950s when she came up with the idea for parties to promote what empire? Was it Mary Kay? Was it Tupperware? Anchor Hawking? Or Ziploc?
What was the lady's name?
Brownie Wise in Florida.
She was in Florida.
Yeah.
So Tupperware or Mary Kay? Mary Kay.
It was Tupperware.
Yeah, I should have gone with my first answer. Tupperware. That's all right. I love me some Tupperware.
Let's do a different category for you.
Okay.
Let's do arts and...
Oh, yes.
Literature and arts, and see how you do.
Literature, yes.
Okay. But Mama always put vodka in her sangria. Adventures in Eating, Drinking, and Making Merry is the title book of what beloved Southern journalist and author? Is it Dave Barry, Roy Blunt, Julia Reed, or Amy Sedaris?
I'm going to say Julia Reed, because Julia sounds like a nice Southern name.
And you're right!
Yay!
That's awesome, sugar.
Look at me go.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. We'll ask you another one.
I'm so well-rounded.
You're very well-rounded. What do you want? Where do you want it?
I'm going back to food.
You're going back to food?
It's my go-to.
It's my go-to. Is this food and drink? Yeah. A kitschy roadside stop called South of the Border, oh God, on Interstate 95 sits near the line of what two states?
North Carolina and South Carolina.
Woohoo! Yeah, you got it. Yes, I've made a stop or two there.
And it is very kitschy.
It's a little kitschy. If, as a matter of fact, our original parents...
Original parents?
I mean, they were like our parents.
Original parents?
Like our parents. Our real parents. They're real. We've only had one
As
set.
Opposed to the two we picked up on the side of the road.
Yes. Okay, Mama and Daddy.
Okay.
They stopped there for one night on their way to Pinehurst for their honeymoon.
Oh, that's so exciting.
I know. I'm surprised they made it out alive.
Where were they coming from?
Virginia, where they got married?
I know, but they would. Why would they go all the way to south of the border and then go back to Pinehurst?
Oh, no. Wait. They went to Florida, too. I think they went to Florida on their honeymoon as well.
Oh, gotcha.
That's all what right. I think.
I'll well, it's very kitschy. If you've never been, you should not.
You should not experience that.
There's a giant sombrero.
You should go, but don't eat anything there.
Oh, my God, no.
And don't use the restroom.
No.
And don't go by yourself. And don't try on any hats.
Oh, Lord, no.
Maybe you should just not go.
Don't go. Just look at it and say, oh, yeah, that's kitschy.
That's kitschy, all right. So I'm going to just pull a card. Pull a card. I don't know what this is back here. I think this is Arts and Leisure again. Bands, the B-52s and REM, both trace their roots back to what small southern town?
Huh.
Is it Athens, Georgia? Louisville, Kentucky. Washington, D.C. is not a southern town.
That's not. That's what the hell?
So we're striking that as even an option. Or Tupelo, Mississippi.
I'm going to say Athens.
And you are freaking right.
I don't know why, but I think Athens.
What? Southern. You thought right, girl. I was so proud of
you. Let me go.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to try to find a hard one for you because you need to mess
up.
No,
I'm good. We need people to think I'm smart.
Traveling places.
Oh, Lord.
Named for its dark, rich soil, what area of Alabama, also a center of activity in the civil rights movement? So, named for its dark, rich soil.
So it's talking about dark, rich soil, but it was also...
the center of activity for the civil rights
movement.
Okay. So it's called, it's either the Piedmont, the Black Belt, the Delta, or the Rich Earth?
I'm going to call it the Delta.
It was the Black Belt.
Really? I've never heard of the Black Belt.
Me too.
But I hadn't heard of the Black Belt either. We'll have to do some research on that.
Black Belt in karate?
That's right. Karate.
I don't even know. All right, here the box is.
All right, should I just pick a random card?
Pick a random. Pick me a random.
All right. Random. Here we go. Why am I doing it from the back like it matters? We'll go. You don't want that. We'll go. Traveling places.
Okay.
What spot in North Carolina was made famous by Orville and Wilbur Wright?
Oh my gosh.
When they took off.
This was meant for me.
For Mia on their first flight.
The Outer Banks, North Carolina.
Kitty Hawk.
Kitty Hawk. Kitty Hawk.
Kitty Hawk.
Kitty Hawk.
Oh, oh.
Pass me that pamphlet. Let's have a recipe break.
Oh, where'd I put it?
It might be underneath your dog.
Are you laying on it, Ralph?
No. Lord of mercy, she done lost the pamphlet.
I did, and I haven't moved from my spot, and I had it.
Okay, well, we won't have a recipe then. That's just weird.
It is really weird that it's gone.
It's gone. Just, it goed away.
Oh, no, Trout, did you move it somewhere?
Oh, is that it right there?
Oh, here it is. I put it on the side table.
Girl,
the Lord have mercy.
All right. So, okay. So we have a couple different recipes still at our party. And I think that what I'm going to talk about is some pick a pepper pecans.
Oh, I love a pecan.
I do too.
Pepper.
I know, and I love pick a pepper.
Pick a pepper pecan.
So this makes 4 cups, and it serves 16 if each of those servings is a quarter cup.
That's a big game night.
It is very, very fun. Okay, so you take 1 pound of pecans.
All right.
And a bottle of pick a pepper sauce.
Well, where do you get that?
Pick a pepper sauce is that, I think Texas Pete makes it. I don't think they're the only ones, but they have the little pickled peppers in it.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? I think that's pick a pepper, but maybe perhaps you should look it up on the Google and see.
You keep going.
Okay. And then you do, so it's a whole bottle of the pick a pepper sauce,
Ooh.
A quarter cup of water, a quarter cup of brown sugar, a teaspoon of kosher salt, and a teaspoon of smoked paprika. You place the pecans in a large bowl and a glass measuring cup. Whisk together your pick a pepper, water, brown sugar, salt, and smoked paprika. Pour over the pecans and let sit for 1 hour.
Wow.
Then you drain them. You preheat your oven at 350 and you baked your drained nuts in a single layer. Make sure your nuts have been drained. And you do it in a single layer sheet pan.
All right.
For 20 minutes, you let it cool on the sheet pan, and you can store in an airtight container up to 1 week. So you can make these ahead of your game night.
So pick a pepper sauce is a Jamaican sauce.
Oh, fun.
It's sweet, mellow flavor of cane vinegar. Makes it a complement to any dish. Pick a pepper products are aged in oak barrels for a minimum of 1 year.
Wow.
Contain only the finest tropical fruits and spices.
Shut up.
You might not like it. Because it's tomatoes, onion, sugar.
And peaches.
Cane vinegar, mangoes, raisins, tamarinds, salt, pebbles, and spices. But you don't like a mango or a raisin.
I don't mind a raisin. But I don't like a mango. But I think it might be buried in all that stuff.
Yeah, it could be.
So it might be something that I could tolerate.
Yeah.
Is there a picture of it?
There is.
Let me see. Pick a pepper.
It is a pick a pepper.
It almost looks like Worcestershire or soy sauce from
right.
here.
Yeah, yeah.
I wonder if our grocery stores even sell that.
I'm sure they do. All right, so now for our party, we've got mint juleps, bacon wrapped crackers, pimento cheese, and pick a pepper pecans.
Yeah, so the last thing that we're going to make, well, we have 2 more things. One is sweet potato candy. Oh, and she also makes deviled eggs.
Oh, that's right. The deviled
eggs. Now, she
eggs.
Puts smoked salmon in hers.
Oh, Lord.
That is optional, and that is not an option that we will take.
No.
But I will tell you that what I do like, she puts white vinegar in there.
Yeah.
And, of course, mayonnaise.
Right.
Whole grain mustard.
Yeah.
She puts a sriracha hot sauce in
Woo!
It.
That's fiery.
And she does 1.5 teaspoons of rendered bacon fat.
Now, that's a good idea. I don't know if I want the pepper in there, but
the sriracha.
I'm not gonna be mad at a bacon fat.
And then salt and pepper to taste.
And it's so
And then chives for garnish.
But now you go into these, they're
fancy
plenty
restaurants.
Plenty of restaurants in downtown Charleston. But these restaurants are making these dang deviled eggs, bro.
And they're selling them for, like, so, it's just crazy.
$8 or $9 and yeah. you get, you know, 4 slices, half a deviled egg.
So it's 2 eggs.
2 eggs, mm-hmm. basically, you're getting for $9.
I know.
It's
now,
crazy.
I will tell you, there is a place downtown called Prohibition, and they have some of the best deviled eggs. You cannot eat them. Because they come with crab meat on top of them.
Oh, wow.
It's chilled crab meat. And then they have the shaved salt.
Right.
That goes on top. And they are to die for. And you get, I think you get 6 for like $10 freaking dollars.
Oh, wow.
But they do have crab meat on them.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and there's this place on Rivers in North Charleston. That's this place called Marie's Diner.
Right. I think you took me there when I first.
I think I did too. It's behind one of the tire places.
Yeah. It's a real shady looking spot.
It's got a Mexican grocery store, a laundromat, a tire place, and this place, Marie's. And I think there's a Vietnamese grocery store in there too.
Right.
And they have really good deviled eggs. Now, her deviled eggs are a dollar. You get two halves for a dollar, but it's the old fashioned.
It's traditional.
It's tradition. Right. It's got the relish in it. It's, you know, it's good.
A little bit of paprika on top. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's good. But some of these places, their deviled eggs are very, very expensive.
Yeah.
Very frou-frou.
Yeah.
For an egg.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
Some of them are good, but some of them are a little much.
Yeah. So the other thing in here in this recipe book that I wanted to look at is sweet potato candy, because I love sweet tater.
And if you're having some sort of a party, you better have a sweet.
Well, excuse me, please. I will say that there's also a recipe in here for a bourbon salted caramel cheesecake with pralines.
There you go.
That I could marry. I could marry that.
Yeah.
But I just want to go over the sweet potato candy because it seems real simple, but I don't think it's simple. So it's a small sweet potato, a teaspoon of vanilla.
You've had it before.
One. I have.
I'm sure you have.
It's got peanut butter in it.
Yeah.
And, oh, my God, I have. You know what? I think our Aunt Mary Ellen used to make this.
I think so.
It's like a peanut butter fudge with some sweet potato in it.
Right. Because
you cook it, and then you mash it, and then you stir in all the other stuff. And then you roll it and put it between. You do the wax paper, and you roll it, and then you chill it, and then you slice it and bake it.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you don't even bake it. You just slice it.
It's done.
Yeah.
It's like, it reminds me a little bit of the inside of the...
Those maple caramel things that we like. Yeah. I don't know what their name of them are, but...
It's got confectioner's sugar, right?
Yeah.
So almost like the inside of a Buckeye, of a peanut butter
bottle. Almost, but it's got sweet tater in it. All right, so I'm going to just talk about this real quick, this cheesecake, and then we will... Each do another thing. What's that thing?
A question.
Trivia. Okay. So she does her 1.5 cups of graham cracker crumbs, 1¾ cups of sugar, 6 tablespoons of butter, 6 8-ounce packages of cream cheese at room temperature, 1½ teaspoons of vanilla, a pinch of salt, 6 large eggs. 3/4 cup of purchased salted caramel sauce, such as Jenny's Splendid Ice Cream Salty, which Jenny's Splendid Ice Cream is here in Charleston, salty caramel sauce, or whatever your preference is.
Right.
2 tablespoons of bourbon, which in my opinion.
Double that.
We could probably double that. And then 12 pralines chopped. So you preheat your oven, you combine your sugar, 1/4 cup of your sugar and your graham cracker crumbs and your butter and a food processor. You blend it until the crumbs stick together and then you press them into the bottom of your springform pan. And then, so you preheat the oven to 350. You bake your crust for 10 minutes and then when you pull that out, you reduce your temperature to 300. Then you mix together your cream cheese, the rest of your sugar, your vanilla, your salt. You mix that until it's very, very smooth. You don't want chunks in your cheesecake.
Lord, yeah.
Then you scrape all of that. You scrape all the sides down. You return, and then you put your mixer back on, and you slowly add your eggs one at a time. And you keep scraping the sides, and then you fold 1/2 cup of salted caramel sauce and the bourbon into the mixture.
Mm-hmm.
And then you pour that in your crust. You make it into a water bath. And then you are going to bake that in your 300 oven for about 50 minutes until the center is set and the rest of the cake has a uniform jiggle. And then after it has a uniform jiggle, then you start checking the cake after 30 minutes. Oh, so you check it every, like you do 30 minutes and then you make sure it's not getting too dark. If it's getting too dark on top, you put foil over top of it. So, and eventually you cook it up, and then it says that you serve it with chopped pralines, which it does not give the recipe for that, but you chop the pralines up and you put it on top of a little bit more of your caramel sauce.
You need a recipe for a praline?
I don't need a recipe, but there is not a recipe included with this recipe. But
I just go down to the...
I would just go buy them.
Down to the market and get myself pralines because they make them the best.
They do. There's no sense in trying to do it. So anyway.
All right. I think I'm going to ask you a couple more questions and then we need to hightail it to Jenny's Splendid to get us some delicious ice cream like Brambleberry Crisp.
Ooh.
Brown Butter Almond Brittle.
That's got my name on it.
Gooey Butter Cake.
Butter Cake.
Caramel Pecan Sticky Bun.
How am I going to... I'm going to have to spend a lot of time at Jenny's.
Lord.
Yeah. That's right down on King
Savannah
Street.
Savannah Buttermint.
Oh, my gosh.
Remember when me mama used to make those buttermints?
Yes. We need to find a recipe for those.
No.
I think we can. That'd be fun. And I like those.
Shape of a leaf.
Yeah. And I like those. And I like cheese straws.
There was always a buttermint and a bowl of nuts. Sometimes some cheese straws or something like that. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Always setting around.
Oh, God.
All right. Ask me a question.
I'm sorry. I was looking at all the ice cream
at
Jenny's.
You're walking through Jenny's virtual ice cream.
Coarsely ground corn kernels cooked in water, broth, or milk is a standard dish in the South and is called what? Oatmeal.
Grits.
Yes, you got it. Grits. But I just want to tell you that one of the options was Bolt milk. Bolt. B-O-I-L. Apostrophe T. Bolt. Bolt milk.
Bolt.
Bolt.
Okay.
I'll ask you one more question.
Give me one more.
We're going literature and art.
Oh, that's not me.
My wound is geography.
What?
It is also my anchorage, my port of call.
That
is the opening line of what Pat Conroy novel? The Great Sanity?
The Prince of Tides.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought, but I was scared.
Don't be scared.
I was scared right there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That was a good one. That was a really, really good
one. I can't believe he's gone.
I know.
R.I.P.
I know. We lost a lot of great authors over the years. It makes me sad.
It does make me sad.
Not having a summer book from Dorothea Benton Frank is just going to break my
heart. It's really awful. Yeah.
I mean, I don't remember the last summer I didn't read a book from her. Just crazy.
Well, I think we're going to wrap it up for our shorty.
Y'all, we're going to Jenny's to get some ice cream. We're not.
I got a hankering for some Jenny's ice cream. I'm sorry y'all are not here to go with us.
Sorry, y'all.
But we love all y'all.
So now you know how to throw a proper game night.
Yes.
Party.
Lord, yes.
You're gonna make your mint juleps. You're going to have your bacon-wrapped crackers, your pimento cheese, your...
Pick a pep of pecans. And your cheesecake. Oh, your candy. Your
sweet potato candy.
Yep.
Actually, so, just wrap those up for a nice... Put them in a little box as a nice...
Oh, that would be a takeaway. Yeah, I do the candy as a takeaway. Yeah.
Cheesecake that... Jesus. Love.
So I think what I would do is when people came in the door, we would have a glass of wine and some pimento cheese and your bacon crackers.
Yes.
And then at the table for game night, I would have my Pica Peppa pecans out.
Yeah.
And of course, we would have our mint juleps.
Set up your mint juleps.
We would have our mint juleps while we're playing.
Mm-hmm.
And then after the game is over, I would serve a little bit of coffee and a bourbon cheesecake.
Mm-hmm.
And then a takeaway would be the sweet potato candies.
That's the perfect summer party, y'all.
Oh, my gosh. Well, y'all. All y'all. We love all y'all.
Now you know how to throw a summer party.
That's
invite
right.
Us. You can invite us. Send our invitation to murder.sugarcoated@gmail.com.
And you can also post pictures of your Southern party on our fan page or tell us what kind of Southern party you would like to throw after the coronavirus is gone.
Which
and
one
we
you're
can
invite us to.
Yes.
What we should wear.
And also let us know on the Instagram as well. And just stay out there and stay safe and wash your damn hands and don't eat shit ribs and Just throw a good party. When this is over, there's going to be lots of partying, girls.
Wash your hands. And then wash them one more time.
And then use some hand sanitizer in case you missed a spot.
Yes. And then we'll come over for your party.
Absolutely. All right, guys. Well, y'all stay sweet.
Have a great week.
Bye now.
Bye.
Thank you for listening to Believe. You can show support to your host by subscribing to the show and giving us a 5-star rating on your preferred platform. Check us out at Believe.com and search for BLEAV on YouTube.